What's going on, my PT peeps, my Walking Dead family, and my fighters? I'm One Eye Bri, also known as PT, and I'm back to talk about The Walking Dead. Spoiler warning for The Walking Dead. Show, comics, spinoffs, movies, all that stuff. Spoiler warning. Now, are these major clues, major hints? What do you make of the information that we're going to share with you? And as always, guys, let me know your thoughts, post your comments below, and shout out to Entertainment Weekly for the article, as well as Sarah, Xmas Girl, and a bunch of other people that shared the article with me. Thank you very much. But first, guys, before we get to it, hit that subscribe button. Helps achieve our goal of 100,000 subscribers. We love talking about The Walking Dead all year round. Hit the join button to become a valued member of our PT channel, Walking Dead Family, and ring the bell if you're a subscriber already to be notified when we post videos every day. Now, here we go. Now, this article was written by Dalton Ross, and it says this. It's a late June afternoon at the Griffin State Probation Office and Day Reporting Center of the Georgia Department of Corrections. But this seemingly abandoned building is bustling with activity and death. The location is doubling as a research facility and infirmary for a key scene in what will serve as Danai Gurira's final episode of The Walking Dead. And the actress, who for 8 years has wowed fans as Michonne, is not going out without a fight. Standing in a blood-soaked hallway filled with health-conscious posters like "Clean Hands, Protect Lives," and "Help Stop the Spread of Syphilis and Gonorrhea," Gurira prepares for the action to come, in which she will have to contend with approximately 20 advancing zombies. The scene calls for her to push 8 flesh eaters down with a gurney, then stab one with her sword, kick another in the chest, carve 2 up, kick one, disembowel another, kick someone down again, and then stab 6 more. Whew! Man, what do you make of that? Well, it's interesting, right? Because it could mean that she is in a facility or building or whatever that connects with Rick and CRM potentially. So it's doubling as a research facility and infirmary. So that takes me back to like season 1 with Shane, Rick, the hospital. It's not connecting the dots with them at all, but it just takes me back to that. Hallways, is it a hospital setting? Is it a hospital facility? Is it something we've seen before? Are we going to see callbacks and connections with Michonne's character from the end of season 2, season 3 when we were first introduced? Or Rick, hospital, connecting points, Grady Memorial type things. Because if it's Michonne's last episode, will we have some sort of connecting point with Rick in the episode? Or is she taken away and we have to wait to the movies? I mean, I doubt the Michonne character is gonna die, but you never know. We all want Michonne and Rick to come together in the movies or the show or whatever, some way in the Walking Dead universe. I hope they come back together. But under the watchful gaze of the episode director and the stunt coordinator, Gurira goes through each of the acts in slow motion while working with her attackers to rehearse and block the scene. I knock you down, I cut you down, I kill you, you're dead, can you fall down so I know you're dead? She then instructs one walker to approach with his right elbow up so she can stick the sword under his arm, asks another if it's okay to both kick and stab him, motions to a biter in the back to come hither to get his, and continues to direct the undead, telling them where to go to get sliced and diced. So I guess it's like a practice run, a dry fit, if you will, but it's pretty awesome to like just think about it. I'm visualizing, okay, Danai is practicing, okay, here, that, you're down, okay, boom, bang, boom. You gotta practice it so it's done flawlessly. But I'm guessing Michonne is not going down without a fight, but where is she? Is she around our group still? Or was she taken away? Michonne is one of the badass fighters of the show, so she's definitely not going down without a fight, but what if she's taken by CRM against her will? Do you really think she would just leave Judith and RJ and everybody because she found something that belonged to Rick? I mean, the threat of the Whispers is pretty crazy. She went to get weapons to fight the Whispers. So I just don't know how she's gonna leave unless she's taken. You need to go over here, so after I take care of this guy, you're waiting for me on the other side. She instructs one of the soon to be obliterated. You're already dead, right? Who's my last kill? Who do I kill last? A zombie raises his hand sheepishly, gets mock stabbed, falls to the floor, and flashes a thumbs up sign. Gurira pauses among all the carnage and looks over at a cameraman. I love to do this, she says with a smile. This is my thing. I'm sure. It's gotta be awesome to take out zombies with knives and swords and guns and spears and everything, right? I mean, you're just having fun, and it's probably something that's awesome and a big part of the job if you're Michonne on the show. So Michonne is an iconic character though, so I highly doubt they're just gonna kill her off. She is made for The Walking Dead. She is an awesome comic and show character. We need her in The Walking Dead universe. Now, I know Danai's doing big things after The Walking Dead, but Michonne is awesome. We love her. And if she never comes back, I'll understand. But I won't like it. Michonne's my favorite character. Ever since Michonne was introduced in Season 2, Episode 13, and Season 3 and beyond, I've loved the character. I've met Danai a bunch of times, and she's an awesome, sweet person and a great actress. Not anymore. While Guerrera burst into the scene in Season 3, playing comic book favorite Michonne, a warrior with a will as strong as sharp as the katana blade she wields feverishly to take out the undead, the 42-year-old is finally sheathing her blade. On a show filled with epic shocks, Guerrera's departure during this last run of Season 10 episodes, we can't say exactly when, is anything but. After all, she has already found huge success moonlighting as Okoye in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, starring in the first comic book film to ever be nominated for a Best Picture Oscar in Black Panther, as well as the highest grossing movie of all time in Avengers Endgame, a star-making cinematic career awaits. And I know Danai Gurira just signed a deal with ABC for a couple years of something, I can't remember what it was exactly, so big things are happening for Danai down the road. But will that impact, if Michonne survives, how she interacts in the Walking Dead universe, where she can go, how big a part will she have in the movies if she survives again? How big a part? Hopefully a big part. But she has to exit the Walking Dead show first. And that's coming up. We only saw one synopsis where Michonne is listed. That's Season 10, Episode 12. Is something going to happen with Virgil? Can we trust him? Does CRM attack the naval base by chance when she's there? So say Michonne goes away, her last episode. Will we have connecting points from when we saw her and her story over the series? If you look at the previous shirt that she had on with Virgil, it's not the same by any means, but the coloring is kind of interesting that it's similar, at least the top is, of the first time we saw the backstory of Michonne to where we saw her leave with Virgil. I'm not saying there's a connecting point, but I love to see connecting points and Easter eggs. Will we see a flashback of Andrea and Michonne? Andrea really, you know, was a connecting point with Michonne. She was introduced by Michonne saving her. So I would say that Andrea impacted Michonne's story. I don't know if the actresses want to come back around and film or what's gonna happen. Maybe it's just they used previously used footage or what, but Andrea was a big part of Michonne's character. And you know, we saw different things with Rick's departure when he left in Season 9, Episode 5. I would love to see callbacks, Easter eggs, connecting points from the story of Michonne throughout the series with Carl. Their first introduction of Michonne. And I can't help to wonder, but the first time we saw Michonne, she looked like this. And a couple of times we saw her with new Walker pets, but in the trailer, one of the more recent trailers, we see that Michonne has new Walker pets. So that's a nice callback for sure. Some people are thinking that Michonne will be taken away by CRM. This is from The World Beyond, not from anything The Walking Dead, but she could be taken away. Maybe she's an A and Rick's a B. And they go to the same place, but different parts, facilities of CRM. I would love that actually. Now this was going around for, you know, a couple months now. You see Michonne in the outfit that we see in the latest trailer. Also, if you look at the cave stuff back there, was her final episode filmed around the same time of the cave for Season 10, Episode 9? And I know Michonne wasn't in Season 10, Episode 9, but it could have been filmed around the same time because I know they filmed Michonne stuff in like June, July. But Michonne is wearing an outfit in one of the trailers that's pretty interesting. She's wearing this outfit when she's holding Lucille, and this is a different look for Michonne. Also, does she come back with Lucille? Is this a dream? Is this even real? We're not sure, but I hope it's real. I want to see what happens here, but again, if she leaves with Virgil and comes back, why does she leave again? And this was another picture of the Michonne rumored last episode. So is this her going back to Oceanside with the guns? But again, if she goes back to Oceanside or Hilltop or Alexandria, why does she leave again? Is she taken? Does she even make it back to Oceanside? So many questions, not enough answers just yet, but I thought the article from Entertainment Weekly was very informative. We see her in a research facility, something that's going down. Is she by herself? I mean, she's taking out 20 walkers by herself. Where's Virgil and those people in the trailer that we see she's with in the woods or she comes across? Do they survive? Can't wait to find out. Let me know your thoughts. Post your comments below. And for those interested in my zombie apocalypse book series, check out the link in the description below. All these books are available now. I hope you join the fight and pick up your copy today, as all the proceeds come back to the book series as well as the PT channel. Thank you guys for watching, and tell them, Daryl. Yeah.
Yo, we love you guys. Honestly, thank you.